I am Eric Helge, Prince of Helge Land, a kingdom by the sea in the land of the Norse. I was 12 when my brother Thorvald the Bold took me on a voyage westward across the sea, beyond the setting sun. The year was 1006 Anno Domini, as time is measured by the Romans. Less than a year earlier, our father, King Urid, had sailed westward on a voyage of discovery beyond where any had gone, and no one ever saw them again. All our kingdom mourns the loss of our father and his men. When my brother Thorvald made the decision to go in search of him, it spread joy throughout the land. Now we sail the powerful sea in our fastest ship, Raven of the Wind. And our hopes and dreams are not only to find the new land of the West, but once again that we might see our father and our people see their king. Second in command was Ragnar, the rover, famed for his raids against the Saxons and the Celts. Ragnar's son, Rorik, a Norseman proven many times in battle. This is Olaf, my brother's most loyal companion. He cannot speak. His tongue was cut out years ago in a raid on the African coast. This is the man who cut it out. Overpowered by Olaf, he now wears the tongue about his neck. There were other berserkers with us. Ivar, Ode, Yubi, and Bijan. All were living legends in our homeland. For each man aboard the Raven was chosen by my brother for his courage in battle and his knowledge of the sea. The wizard, called Death Dreamer, was a dark and foreboding figure whose presence caused uneasy muttering among the crew. No one had ever seen his face, and he was always with his falcon. My brother, Thorvald the Bold, a warrior feared and respected by all Norsemen, the strong right arm of my father. And our homeland has been peaceful and prosperous for many years due to his great strength.
Spin your spells, wizard. Look through the dark of the storm. Tell me, is there danger ahead?
The storm will break. On the morrow, a new land.
New land? What say your signs about this new land?
A fertile land will welcome us. But in the days to come, danger will follow.
Stay below, young Eric. Tonight, the sea carries danger.
Praise be to our god, Odin, for we have indeed found the new land of the West. To Odin!
To Odin!
To Odin!
To Odin!
To Odin!
Thank you.
fear for news of the strange sounds we'd heard from up the beach. The coming of footsteps that I quickly recognized gave me a sigh of relief. As I approached him that morning, I will never forget the look in his eyes from behind the sacred mask.
You spoke to me of danger in days to come, wizard. If you ever fail me or my men again, I'll send you out to sea on a Norse raft. Praise thee, Odin. For ye have allowed Bijan to die, as only a Norseman should ever die.
John's body was sent to sea, to Valhalla, for he had died with his sword in his hand.
Ragnar, up the beach is an inlet to a big river.
Anything else?
No sign of civilization.
In the woods there are the sweetest grapes I've ever tasted.
It will be written that this new land will be called Vineland.
Wizard, what say you? You know what we know not. You see what we see not. Who killed Bijan? Where are they? How many of them are there? Have you lost your wits, or had you none to start with?
It would have been a blessing had Odin taken you rather than Bijan.
You'll have no arm, and he no head.
Enough.
This vile, odorous.
Tomorrow we sail the river. Come, Eric.
Sail the river. I'll speak with him on this.
And I predict that on the morrow you'll be at the prow of the ship.
We had had a startling welcome to this new land. Already one dead and an unknown enemy. With every stroke of our oars, I began to doubt more and more if my father was still alive. If his long ship indeed had really landed upon this new land, if so, then he surely met with the same enemy. Whatever reason my brother had for sailing further inland on this narrow river was for no one to question. For he had brought us across the wide and vengeful sea safely. He moved to the prow of the ship. And there he stood for almost all that first day. His eyes searching the shoreline. His face showed us his determination.
We are in a vulnerable position. We've been led down this river purposely, and now we're sitting here like women, waiting to be taken. We need the mighty sea at our backs. The sea is our protector.
Oh.
Since we were children, we have protected our homeland by spilling the blood of our enemy. Our shores are laden with the remains of intruders whose ambitions were far greater than their fighting skill. Not once have any of us ever turned from a challenging sword or a foreign ship that may have threatened us. The day that I turn my sails and hide from a new enemy will be the day that I become like a woman in my homeland. I'm asking you now, since when have we as Norsemen ever turned our backs in seeking out our own kind? Never. Never. When that day approaches in the life of a Norseman, we will all drop our swords into the deepest part of our mother sea.
Lord Thorvald, we will keep our ship at anchor and post our guards. We must all take certain risks to try to rescue our comrades. And we are with you. Odin!
Good, you've made this decision. But with it, you must face a terrifying discovery. I have seen King Yorick in my dreams. There is great danger for him and your men as well.
Tend your bird, wizard, for I have made my decision.
Oh, They haven't bound us since the first days of our capture.
But they can easily be removed.
That's not what bothers me. They're afraid of something. What's wrong? What is it? I know you don't understand what I'm saying. Is something wrong? Someone coming.
Come, my lord.
At last. They have come across the great waters to return us to our homeland.
It's time to put away your scroll and rest.
Will I be allowed to go into the forest tomorrow to search out the new land?
Young Eric, if you were to venture inland with us, who would I trust to leave in charge of the ship?
I was disappointed when he told me I couldn't go. But I knew this was not the time for me, as a lad, to be journeying into unknown regions. Day by day, I had written down the events of our journey and kept my hopes high that I would finally record the finding of our father.
Berserkers. Hola! Wedge, quickly!
my Lord Thorvald. On the morning light, shall we leave the river and put our mother sea at our backs?
We will not. On the morrow, we will seek out to find my father and his loyal companions, to see if indeed they are alive.
But after all the losses we suffered today, we cannot
return to your men. And remember the Battle of Rodan.
We as Norsemen, outnumbered, hurt, retreated, and therein returned to slay the Saxons.
I remember well the Battle of Rodan. I was there. I remember well today's battle. I was there too.
Wizard!
Come in, wizard.
Enter, wizard.
What advice do you have for me?
They are many. They are like no enemy you've ever faced. They live here in this land just as the wild animals live in the high mountains of our homeland. To go into the forest after them is worse than crossing the high Alps to kill a white bear with empty hands.
Go.
Begone!
For battle. I'm gonna fight with you.
Eric, I think we have to speak.
Speaking's over. Now we're gonna fight.
They're celebrating the battle, my king.
You're right. For I remember only too soon our capture and the death of our men. The night of the same celebration and the betrayal of Kiwonga.
indeed they are here, wouldn't the long ship be on the shore of the Mother Sea?
Or it could be lying at rest in the river where we had sailed.
But choose me, my lord. For with my bare hands, I'll kill the guards.
It is not over yet. When the time is right, we will fight as Norsemen once again, for Odin will be our eyes, and our strength and hearts have always been that of the Norse. All we can hope for now is that the girl will help us. Maybe because of her help, the battle has not yet been decided. There were no Norsemen brought here tonight as captives. I believe they will return soon to bring us home.
Same woman we saw before.
Tis a trap, I'll wager on it.
Oh, well, perhaps. We will make her come to us. Take up the crossbows.
Crossbows! We're too close to shore.
Make the men ready.
Bowman, watch the woods.
Your arrows. It's coming aboard.
Who is she?
I don't know. But she has our father's dagger. Go below, Eric. This blade belonged to my father, our king, Eric. She wants us to follow her.
Into an ambush.
Perhaps. But she risked her life. Olaf, Thrall, Ivar, Yubi. We'll go with the girl. Olaf, It is a trap. Kill her first. Led us to our king. We'll return.
Again tonight, they are preparing for battle.
When they come, we'll be ready. Yours.
Let me have your hands. To Odin. To Thor. To Rolf. A true Norseman.
I believe Raven of the Wind will be attacked heavily from the banks of this river before the end of the day. With my sword and the help of Odin, I will bring our king and his men out of bondage. You, Ragnar, will meet us on the shore of our mother's sea before this day is past.
We were 2 days coming from the sea. Now you ask me to do the impossible.
Little brother, when I return to meet you by the shore of the Mother Sea, I hope to be greeted by a young Norseman and not a full-grown toad.
What does he look like, young Eric?
To Eric! To Eric!
You'd better go make peace with the wizard. You know, of course, if we do not return by this day's end, you're to take Raven of the Wind and these men to their homeland. Ragnar.
Wizard, I'll tell you a secret. I have no belief in your spells and magic, your dreams and prophecies. Today is your chance to prove me wrong. So spin your spells, work your best magic. For if my ship does not reach the sea to meet Lord Thorvald, before this day is done, your head will float in the sea.
Don't worry, young Eric. They will return.
And if they don't?
Then we will go after them.
Coming soon.
our fault.
Father. Sire. Your eyes.
As the gods would have it. As Odin has been my strength, you will be my eyes.
Sire, we must hurry.
Lord Ragnar, what now?
This day is far from finished.
My brother and the berserkers had been gone for hours, and we'd moved back downriver for only a short distance. Lord Ragnar knew without the wind to help us, it would be doubtful a raven could reach the sea by the time the sun set. Left with only a few of the older men, we indeed now needed a miracle. We had but a few hours of light left. Two more of our younger men were dead. The wizard was deep in thought. Suddenly it began. I felt it on my face. It had finally come. The wind. The wind straight from the heavens. Oh, how they blew.
Hoist the sails!
hurry. Command you, come. It will be written that the name of Olaf shall live on in the land of the Norse.
Thorvald has ordered Raven of the Wind to sail safely home at the setting sun. Thank you.
man is dead.
He was dead when we left the cave, but he deserves a Norse burial.
Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on!
Get them to the stern! Help them aboard!
Eric. Eric. My son.
Father.
Thank you.
Norseman, places! Our wizard, ship this oar.
Ready on the oars.